What's the worst place you have laughed uncontrollably? This one time at a funeral, my cousins and I saw an older gentleman approach the casket. It was a open casket. And he started talking. No big deal. But what he said killed us. It was something like, "Hey Jude, I'd ask how you're doing, but you're dead." My boss gave a talk to a squad of disabled athletes in wheelchairs, and not only did he say that it's important to put your best foot forward, but he also said, "A journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step." I had to leave the room. Well, it wasn't uncontrollable, but there were a lot of laughs at my mom's funeral. My grandmother, who was 96 at the time, and having a bit of dementia, said out loud, "Oh, you shut your mouth," when the priest started his prayers. It actually lightened up a grim room. They started playing the Hallelujah song at school. My friend asked, "Isn't this the song from Shrek?" In a staff meeting, when they told us the store was closing, and we would all be losing our jobs. It was the first mandatory full staff meeting in the 2 years I had been there. Usually the warehouse area where I worked would do those things separately. I was joking in the carpool to work that we were all getting laid off in one go to save time. And when we get there, the big boss has tissue boxes lining the meeting table. I knew I was right and immediately started giggling like an idiot. I kept it together, kinda, until they announced the layoffs. And then I lost it. Other people were in tears for losing their jobs, but the whole thing was weirdly hilarious to me. At my mother's baptism, my mother was raised Catholic, but grew away from the church for various reasons over the years. But she became very active at a local Baptist church, and decided to officially convert. They held a huge ceremony during the Sunday morning service, and the whole family showed up to support her. Well, there is always music and singing. And being a fairly large church, they had a band with a multitude of instruments. There was this one freaking guy, and his job was to play the chimes. You know, the different ones hanging on strings all in a row? Well, let me tell you, this guy loved to play the freaking chimes. It was his only job. He did it with such flourish. He would shove his hand into the air before swooping into the hanging bars of metal. Did you know that he was also able to incorporate chimes into multiple points of all the songs played? Well, he did. Chimes all day. The first time it happened, my husband and I locked eyes in the pew. That was it. We freaking lost it. And he kept doing it. Song after song. We could not get control of ourselves. My father, sitting behind us, was furious. At my roommate's father's funeral. Extremely depressing because his father took his own life. However, there was an old fella in attendance who let out the slowest, clappiest fart of all time. I couldn't help myself. In a haunted horror maze, the owners and actors clearly put a lot of time and effort into making it look and feel incredible. But on the first jump scare, my adrenaline spiked, and I couldn't control the constant laughter that followed me the rest of the way. Absolutely shattered the tension for everyone. My wedding vows. Husband got through his, then hit a giggle loop that had me struggling to get through mine. To the point where I was a little late on a few responses and my dad asked, "Mom, is she crying?" "No, no, she's laughing." Went to a friend's church when I was 20, and at one part of the service people started standing up sharing their struggles. Lots of tears. Really somber mood. Lady in front of me stands up, and she's ugly crying. Snorting. Sniffling. Voice cracking and squeaking, and it struck me as funny. I started giggling, so I bent over in the pew to make it look like I was crying. My redneck friend, sitting beside me, started patting my back and rubbing my shoulders comfortingly, which made it even funnier, and I started belly laughing. But all bent over, covering my face, it looked like I was absolutely falling apart, and trying to hold it in, I started to make my own weird gasping, snorting sounds. My friend never knew until years later, when I was telling the story at a party. When the small turboprop plane hit really bad turbulence and dropped a bit. Lady screamed. Children cried. I was laughing hysterically. Wife was unimpressed. Which of course made the laughing worse. 10 tenths. I was interviewing a woman for a part-time job in our office, when I realized that, if you dipped her in blue paint, she would be the spitting image of Nanny Smurf. I started to crack up, and realized I was going to lose it in front of her. So I told her I was having an allergy attack. I ran to the bathroom and laughed my head off. Went back and finished the interview. The toilet. Standing while taking a piss. Remembered something hilarious. Piss everywhere. My dad's funeral. It started with the honor guard got lost between the funeral home and cemetery, and we saw them turn into the cemetery on two wheels right before the hearse got there. It grew when the shells from the 21 gun salutes fell out of the flag when they handed it to my mom. Then we got stranded in the cemetery because the limo wouldn't start after the service and almost everyone else was gone. We spent 10-15 minutes just laughing in the cemetery. We all figured that dad couldn't have planned it better. Heathrow Airport sometime in the 90s. There was a 1 minute silence for Princess Diana. My girlfriend burst into uncomfortable laughter. It was so infectious that I ended up in fits of laughter. I still feel bad. Back of an 8th grade classroom during a presentation. I'm bullcrapping with my friend because I'm kind of a peen. Meanwhile, our student presenter has a small but noticeable speech impediment. Every couple of words, he has to pause and catch his breath mid-word. Thank you. While not paying attention to the presentation, my friend made me laugh, which happened to coincide perfectly with one of the pauses. I immediately feel an entire classroom of eyes on me as I try to look innocent and point at my friend as the object of laughter. But it was too late. No way to talk yourself out of that mess. After receiving my final test of the year, and it all seemed like some freaking exorcism. Next to a dead body, elderly lady had fallen out of bed, lit a cigarette and promptly died. She had such a mad off look on her face. Like, great. Fell out of bed. Can't get up, and what's this? A heart attack? Well, why the frick not? Oh. Man. I used to work in a call center. And on each call I had to inquire whether the customer had cavity wall and loft insulation already. On one call I accidentally asked somebody if they'd had their caft and lovety warped, immediately bursting into an insane fit of giggles. Thankfully the person on the other end of the phone saw the funny side. Honestly, just typing that out now I'm having to suppress the giggles. I ended the call and had to take a break to let all of the giggles out and compose myself. Eventually I calmed down enough to make another phone call, and for whatever reason, as soon as the next person answered the phone I burst back into giggles. The customer was not impressed. I explained caft and lovety warped and apologized to the guy, but he told me how unprofessional it was and that it made my company look bad etc etc. I apologized profusely but still couldn't really stop giggling. He hung up shortly after that, and TBH. Frick that guy. Because caft and lovety warped is hilarious. Not the worst. But I've done it at the movies a few times. Once during Mad Maximum Fury Road and again watching the first Jurassic World. One friend insisted in seeing them in 3D. For some reason. When the guitar player in Mad Maximum came flying off the truck in 3D. I lost my crap and could not pull myself together. And I have a pretty loud belly laugh cackle. I unintentionally made a scene in the theater. Same deal with Jurassic World. When the guy who is talking about weaponizing the velociraptors tries to hold out a hand to calm one down, and it starts by eating his arm, then killing him. The 3D in that movie was meh, and this was one of the few times it kind of worked. And again, for some reason, I lost my mind laughing. We don't go to 3D movies anymore. At my son's funeral, my daughter, 10 at the time, got her hair caught in my niece's earring, while my daughter was resting her head on her cousin's shoulder. It was a nice 5-minute laughing session by the three of us, but people behind us thought we were crying. In an elevator full of people. It was my first time being baked in public. My grandma's funeral. She was wearing a brooch that was given to her on a previous birthday. We played a joke on her before she was given the brooch and her reaction was hilarious. I walked up and looked at her, saw the brooch and just started laughing. I got yelled at a bunch. Once I explained, everyone laughed a little also. Several years ago working in a law firm, had a case where a gay couple with a civil union from another state was splitting up. New York didn't recognize the union. One party wanted to be an equity court rather than law. Meeting with my boss about it, and he drops the phrase, backdoor into equity. Yesterday during yoga, one of the girls that I invited fell asleep in the first sitting pose. We are standing there doing sun salutations, and she's still sitting there asleep af. I busted out laughing and couldn't stop. Was getting into the hearse on the way to my grandma's funeral. My sister had pulled out her phone, opened Pokemon Go, and was in the process of catching a Charizard next to the hearse driver's door. She noticed me staring, looked me dead in the eye and solemnly said, "Gotta catch 'em all." At passport control in Canada, the guy was busting my ass for spending a lot of time in the Middle East, and I was like, "You are one to talk, Officer Abbas." He was not amused. But then we started talking about throwing tobanis at strippers, and he was happy. Friend's sister came in, and in a serious tone, said Disco is dead, which made me chuckle. Then she told me Disco was a person. I didn't know this. I hit that awkward hysterical laughter, and had to leave. My friend forgave me. His sister, understandably, not so much. Funeral for my ex-husband's grandma. My son was only 6 weeks old, and hadn't pooped in a few days. My ex-H was holding him, standing beside me as the priest was doing the eulogy. My son finally released his several days worth of poop, which was significant enough that we referred to it as a poonami. It wasn't super loud, but I could hear it standing right there, and it went on for quite a while. My ex and I looked at each other and started silently laughing so hard, trying to hold it in. Later people came up to us to express their condolences, thinking we had been sobbing not laughing. National Healthcare Conference Award Ceremony. Was in a huge banquet hall and there was an open wine bar. Two ladies and I got a little sloshed and started playing I Never at our table. Very inappropriate giggling pursued. For the next hour, surrounded by hospital executives. Was also an intern at the time. Trying to get a permanent job. Kinda stupid. My grandma's funeral. I was sitting next to my 6-year-old nephew, and he turns to me with his middle finger up while asking, "Do you know what this means?" I was like, "My little dude, where did you even learn that?" And he told me that he saw his friend's brother do it, and he wanted to know what it meant. I'm the worst auntie for saying that it's showing where grandma is going, which is up into heaven. This damn child got up on a chair with two of his middle fingers up and dramatically said she was the best grandma. My mom had set her face on fire when I was in high school. While in the ambulance on the way to the hospital, I was sitting in the front seat and looked at the dash and noticed there was a knob for the siren. I saw two labels. One was wail, the other yelp. I asked the driver if the third was shriek. This, along with several other inappropriate quips, gave me some really strange looks. But considering it was like 4 a.m. when it all went down and there wasn't an adult around, I was just trying to hold it together. At a wedding, while the vows were being spoken, because some dude sitting in the pew in front of me farted, and no one else seemed to hear or acknowledge it, except for me, I couldn't stop laughing, and the plus one who was with me kept elbowing me to get me to stop, which made me laugh even more, because she didn't know what I was laughing at. My so and I were out to brunch at Macaroni Grill. They serve all you can drink mimosas, which is always a great time. We get a nice buzz going, and they have the tables covered in paper, so they bring you crayons to draw with. I started labeling everything but was abbreviating everything. Olive oil, O, juice, water, H2O, balsamic vinegar, B, vin. I lost it. I don't know why, but the word bevin got to me, and I couldn't stop laughing. The waiter came by and immediately left. Not me, but I caused it. We had a teacher in the 10th grade, who was gone for a bit, and upon her return, was explaining to the class that her father had passed away, and that's why she took time off. I wasn't paying attention to what she was saying, and neither was my friend across the room, when I made a stupid face at him. He burst out laughing literally as she said her father had passed away. He couldn't even get words out to explain what had happened when the entire class was staring at him, including a disgusting look from the teacher. Ad for helping people with Down syndrome that was playing before a movie. Orchestra where Bernie Sanders' doppelganger was playing a cello solo. I actually felt absolutely terrible for this. But I was at Game 6 of last year's playoffs between the Toronto Maple Leafs and the Boston Bruins. And they announced they were holding a moment of silence for the victims of the Toronto van attack. I went with my buddy from work, and we had been drinking all day. Buddy wasn't listening to the announcement and, right after it ended, he yells "Lucic gets wrecked." The combination of his bizarre inflection, the following complete silence afterwards, and the fact that Milan Lucic, who he was referring to, hasn't played for the Bruins in years, made my wasted ass cry laughing. I tried to stifle it, but didn't do a good enough job. And after the silence, a couple behind us were loudly exclaiming how unbelievably rude the two guys laughing were. I can't blame them all. Walmart. There were two stalls in the back bathroom. I had to take a huge crap and ran in. Before I could comfortably let it all loose, another guy runs in and takes the stall next to mine. So we're both trying to be quiet poopers when the guy next to me finally whispers "ooh-ooh" to himself before letting out a little squeak of flatulence, which made me giggle really hard and made me defecate with a flatulent pop. It was quiet for like 1.5 seconds, and then both me and the guy in the next stall start laughing uncontrollably while crapping and letting the most indescribable sounds leave our asses for what must have been a good minute or two. After it was over, there was awkward silence of paper being torn and applied gently, and then we realized we were both done. But neither of us actually wanted to meet, so he just says "you first." So I left the stall, washed my hands, and as I left the bathroom I heard his stall open. Point, I never looked back, but I think about it often. TLDR, a guy and I pooped while laughing in a bathroom at the same time. When I was in 5th grade, the police officers of my town came to the school to give us a talk about road safety. They suddenly showed us an image of a person dodging a train, and I started laughing while the rest of the class was in silence. The teacher decided to kick me out of the class and made me wait in the corridor. When I worked retail, I used to giggle maniacally from stress whenever a customer would get upset with me, which luckily didn't happen often, but it was never well received. An older wasted man once told me he was going to make me stop giggling with force if necessary, and for some reason I replied, "That's hot," which just enraged him even more. Eventually another customer helped get him out of the store, and I was so grateful I gave him a thank you BJ. Here's a word of advice: don't attend a car crash as part of a first date. Back when I was first trying my hand at online dating, I made plans to meet up with a young woman at a coffee shop near a beach. Like many such doomed from the start affairs, this one began with a lot of small talk, a discussion about the surrounding area, and a couple of allegedly humorous misunderstandings. For a little while, it seemed like it was going to be an unremarkable excursion, but just as the conversation was actually getting started, we were interrupted by the loud screech, pop, and crunch of a fishtailing car plowing into a nearby tree, as is wont to happen in such circumstances. Many of the cafe's other customers gathered around to gawk at the scene. Murmurs of speculation rippled through the small crowd as we all watched the car's driver climb out and survey the damage, followed by gasps of shock and alarm as people noticed that her head was bleeding. One of the nearby employees went to call 911, and my date asked if we should try to help the woman. I was about to respond with my agreement, but the words never came out, largely because they were replaced by uproarious laughter. Please understand, I wasn't making light of the car crash. In fact, at the exact moment that I'd been encouraged to assist, I'd caught sight of something that my brain decided was too funny to ignore. From behind the wreckage, there came an enormous, almost spherical man riding on a motorized bicycle. He looked to be about 50, had an expression of intense concentration on his face, and was moving so slowly that it really seemed like he should have toppled over. Each of the man's limbs were frozen in place, statue-like, as the dull whine of the vehicle's motor struggled to inch him forward. I don't know why I found that so amusing, but I couldn't stop myself from laughing. Tears of mirth clouded my vision, and no matter how hard I tried to restrain myself, I just couldn't stymie my amused outburst. Needless to say, it didn't make the best impression on the girl across the table from me, and I could feel the disapproving stares of the other patrons from all around. I did finally manage to explain what had caused me to break down like I had, but I'm not convinced that the young woman believed me. We didn't have a second date, but to be honest, I still chuckle to myself when I picture the man on his moped. TL, doctor, my first date with a girl was a literal car wreck, but it also gave me my funniest memory. I was visiting family in Zimbabwe. A street peddler was trying to sell us goods as we walked to Vic Falls. Suddenly a small truck stopped, and out popped a man in camo shouting and pointing an assault rifle in our direction. I thought it was directly at me, but it was at the man next to me. My response was uncontrollable laughter from stress. My cousin was not amused as this was the way it was in this country. I also was not amused, but I never explained why I burst out laughing. Poetry class. Senior year of college. Easier, am I right? Professor wanted to show us that strings of words can flow like notes in a symphony. So he had us listen to Mozart's Requiem and appreciate the sounds. The top comment said, "This is what I listen to when I take a dump." I laughed so hard that he told me to get the frick out of his class. When I first met my husband's parents, they invited some of their extended family out for dinner. My husband's aunt told me this story. An elderly man they knew was island hopping in Indonesia and got into a small plane of about 10 people. The plane's engine failed or something like that, haha, and it nosedived into the ocean. 9 passengers died. This man they knew was the only survivor and was picked up by a passing boat. He went into hospital, where they were sure he was on his deathbed with pneumonia. After a month of being in hospital in a foreign country, his family demanded he be transported back home. After another month in hospital, finally he made a recovery and returned home. For his first breakfast back home, he asked that it be served on his balcony. He sat down on his chair on the balcony and waited for his breakfast to be served. The balcony fell off the house and he died. I think it was the phrasing "fell off the house" combined with nerves at meeting my husband's family for the first time that made me completely lose my mind. I was wiping away tears. The worst part is that no one else heard the story, and when they asked the aunt what was so funny, she said I was just telling her how so and so passed away. Whoops. I was getting into a notoriously crappy elevator with my uncle when the door slammed on his shoulders really hard and made him grunt in shock. I couldn't stop myself from laughing at him and felt awful about it, especially when I found out later that it really hurt and that my laughter had made him feel bad. Last year I was at my great grandma's funeral. I was very, very close to her growing up all my life. She passed away at the ripe age of 97. My good friend came to the funeral, and he sat off somewhere else, since I had to sit in the front row. And he kept on texting me inside jokes and just funny stuff in general, and it kept me laughing through all my tears. I was very sad but happy at the same time. I'm glad he was there. Church. When the topic was on sexuality, the pastor was super passionate and yelling, "Anal sex is a sin. Homosexuality is a sin. And don't get me started on sexual relations with your mother." I don't go to that church anymore for a variety of reasons. But my loud giggling and cackle snorts got a lot of people riled up. Some church pastors are extremely entertaining when buzzed on alcohol. I have problems, but don't knock it until you try it. In 10th grade history class, we watched Schindler's List. For those of you who haven't seen it, it's freaking miserable. So there's this one scene where Schindler and Stern figure out a way to get a whole train full of Jewish prisoners released so they can work in Schindler's factory. Except there's a goddamn paperwork error, and instead of being saved, the train starts heading to freaking Auschwitz instead. Literally the worst place it could possibly go. It was just such an over-the-top plot point. Even if it's completely true, it's just so insane that I started busting out laughing in the middle of the classroom while some other kids were crying. It was a really bad look. I'm a medic. During a cardiac arrest, we're in the back of the truck working the guy, and the ambulance suddenly fills with a terrible smell. My partner says, "I think the patient just voided his bowels." "Wow, that's awful." Me: "No, I just farted." We both started laughing horribly, and the guy driving the rig for us, a firefighter from one of the local departments, had no idea what was going on. We kept doing our job, but I'm glad no family was around for it. Every year on Christmas Eve, my friend's grandparents read the story of Jesus, and just the fact that we should respectfully remain quiet and listen makes us get the giggles every year. Mind you, I'm 21. Last year, many people pasted, so it was an emotional time. Well, we got the giggles during the reading and couldn't stop. About 3 of us got the giggles and couldn't stop. I tell you. Giggles make you weak. During our efforts to stop, my mistake of a brother stretched out his leg to help pinch off the fart that was about to implode during the dead silence. Unfortunately, it only helped to turn that silent fart into a high-pitched 2-minute screech that quickly overpowered the room. The highly religious grandparents were not impressed with our display, and my mom quickly dragged my still farting brother out into the other room and beat him while still farting and while still laughing. Best sort of Jesus ever. Mad impact panel. An old lady fell asleep and snored incredibly loud as parents were telling the group about how their daughter was killed by a wasted driver. Everyone in the room was losing it, quietly, and the parents kept stopping mid-sentence to try to collect themselves. I felt pretty bad. While getting a ticket from a cop, he was a real jerk and took his job way too seriously. Honestly, I don't know what came over me, but I couldn't help but start busting up laughing at him. Hint, don't do this. He yelled at me more. P.S. I also had my daughter in the car, and somehow it makes it doubly worse. Me and a friend were at a doner store, German/Turkish food, and behind us stood some annoying little boys, maybe 12. They were acting like some sort of gangster, talked really loud, and annoyed the crap out of everybody. One of them said very loudly, "Oh man, do I love Aaron some Turkish drink." My friend turned around, looked him straight in the eye, and said, "And I love you." I completely lost my crap. Couldn't even order anymore. On the set of the show SEAL Team during a take. I'm a background actor, so I'm on lots of shows, either just sitting somewhere or walking back and forth in the distance. I'm also a huge Bojack Horseman fan, so I think David Boreanaz is hilarious. I start laughing a little whenever a commercial of his comes on. So when I was supposed to be sitting there eating a fake meal during a take, he is having dialogue right behind me with all the cameras rolling, and I just could not keep it together. 6th grade at the Holocaust Museum. The teachers made the biggest deal about none of us laughing or screwing around, so by the magic of reverse psychology, everybody was just keyed up and ready to go. As we are walking around looking at the exhibits, my friend, R.I.P., leans over and says, "Bill Nye the Nazi spy," and everybody just loses their crap. The teachers were so mad, but they brought it on themselves by making such a big deal about it. Information while in boot camp. My friend and I were talking about music from when we were in middle school and high school as we come back to the office from lunch. I mentioned how, while I was relaxing the night before, Biob by System of a Down came on my Spotify, and we started laughing about how ridiculous and amazing SOD was. My friend then does a perfect impression of the "Why do they always send the poor" scream. At this point, we just walked past the receptionist and into the quiet parts of the office, and I start laughing uncontrollably. You know those times where you try and be quiet while laughing, but you can't, and you just end up being just as loud? That was me that time. The people staring at me were not happy. I will never live down the shame. My old roommate and I were hanging out when he told me his dad got some bad news from the doctor. I was preparing for the worst when he started talking about it. He looked me in the eye and told me he has lung cancer, and I just freaking lost it. I busted out and laughed in his face for a solid 3 minutes, and half of that was me laughing at the fact that I was laughing. I was mortified. He took it like a champ, and we are still buds. The second I'm pretty fond of. My nephew was being baptized and I was going to show up. The family knows I'm atheist, but I'll still show up because it's important to his mom. Anyway, they tell me it's at 10 when in reality the baptism was at 12 and 5 the service was at 10. Fine. I can appreciate someone telling a crowd of people no to be an asshole. Sermons are usually just goo messages, so I'll hang out. I'm half listening when the third pastor comes out for her sermon. Very new age church with a coffee shop, playground, lots of money. While she is wrapping up, she does the whole spiritual riffing thing where they improvise a closing prayer. Everyone has their heads down while she speaks, and I'm just passively listening until she says one thing that shakes me out of my own head. "Thank you for looking down on us today, Jesus. We kneel before your grace with open arms. Come down upon us, Jesus. Come down." Then is crap you not the next thing that she says is this: "Come on us, Jesus. Come on all of us in your glory." I laughed so hard I cried. I didn't expect that at all, and I was floored. My family looked as devastated as if Jesus had actually came all over the audience. My brother sitting next to me couldn't handle it and laughed at me laughing. To the pastor's credit, she didn't skip a beat. Finished up and didn't even acknowledge the freaking hyena in the middle row. Anyway, I'm glad I could share those stories. Yes, I feel awful about the first one.